So once again, good afternoon to one and all. Good afternoon to 9th class children. So today we are going to deal with session 6 or lecture 6 of ID subject 402 code. So in that first chapter, that is called as Fundamentals of Computers. So today we can deal with session 6 or lecture 6. So as we learned in previous sections, session 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. So continuation of that one, next one. So in this class, today we are going to deal with lecture 6 or session 6, translators. So as our school name or institute name is CSRGS Junior College number jo hai, Information Technology subject code is the 402, chapter number or is the one, and topic is Fundamentals of Computers. In this session 6 or lecture 6, I am going to deal with translator, and this is the email ID for admission purpose or any inquiries. So now we can deal with the translator. So today I am going to deal with the translator definition and types of translators, and the differentiation between the translators or differences. Okay, now we can deal with the definition of translator. As I am telling, translator meaning is there only translator which will translate. What will translate? So it will translate into one programming language into another language. So which programming language? That one we can see now. Okay, translator, as I am telling, translator, it is defined as a code converter. How we can define a translator? Translator is defined as a code converter. It is called as a code converter. So translator is, it is a code converter which is used to translate or convert one programming language into another programming language. So that I am telling, one programming language is, so as in previous class session 5 we learned some of the programming languages. That's why to take translators I explained that one. So one by one link is there, like that I will try to explain. Okay, so translator, it is defined as a code converter which is used to translate or convert one programming language or one code into another code. So which programming language? So that all things we can study in the different types of the translators. So first we must become perfect with the definitions, then we can go to the types of the translators. So hence once again I am telling, translator is defined as a code converter. It is defined as a code converter or language converter which will convert one code into another code, one program into another programming language, one programming language into another programming language, one code into another code. That is called the translator. Okay. So maybe there are three different types of translators are there. So one is called as, three types of translators are there. One is called as, it is called as the, it is called as, first one is called as, it is called the interpreter. Second one is called as interpreter. Second one is, it is called as the compiler. Third one is called as assembler. These are the translators. Okay, how we can define interpreter, compiler, assembler means what? Interpreter. First one is interpreter. How we can define interpreter? So interpreter I am going to define by using the diagram. As previous class I learned what is meant by HLL, I explained everything in detail. That's why I am taking the next concept like this I am going to teach. And here I am telling I want to define this interpreter diagrammatically. We can make it easy. We can write your own definition. Interpreter. This is called as the interpreter. And here our computer, it understands one language that I explained in previous class. Session 5. Now it is easy to understand step by step. Okay. So this is called as HLL. This is called as MLL. This is the interpreter. Okay. Now, interpreter, I can define like this. Interpreter is defined as, it is a language translator or code converter which will convert one programming language into another language and vice versa. One programming language is what? HLL. HLL means what? High level language. High level language example means what? It may be C, C++, like this. Okay. But here, interpreter means we have to consider the examples of basic, Logo, COBOL, like this. These are the examples because nowadays we are not using. So, these languages are used to convert into ones and zeros and result back into HLL by the interpreter. Hence, interpreter is called as the language translator or the code converter which converts HLL high level language into machine level language and machine level language back to high level language. So, this diagram you cannot get in some books. Directly they will write HLL into MLL. They will stop. But actually, we must give reverse back also. Vice versa also we have to tell, otherwise it is wrong. Because why vice versa? Because we are giving the input in terms of English language. That will be given to the MLL or machine level language, machine or computer. It will process. Again code will be into ones and zeros. We cannot understand. So that's why that will be again converted back to HLL so that we can understand the result. We are going to do the input. We must understand the output correct or not. That's why. So it must be converted back. So it must be converted back with the help of interpreter. Interpreter is called as a translator or language translator or code converter. So this is the definition of interpreter. But only one thing is that interpreter, it is used or applied for these programming languages or HLLs. Interpreter nowadays we are not going to use, because nowadays these languages we are not going to use. We are going to use for study purpose in school level and college level, but rarely. That's why interpreter nowadays we are not using, because interpreter, it is very very slow to convert the program. It takes a lot of time. It is like a cycle or bicycle. So that's why we are not using nowadays. Okay, then we can deal with next one, compiler. Compiler, I am writing here almost same definition, compiler. But what is the difference? I will tell you. Compiler here. So compiler, in place of interpreter, I am going to add this compiler. Remaining thing will be the same, but one thing I change. Compiler is defined as the language translator or code converter, which will convert one programming language into another programming language and vice versa. It will convert HLL, high level language, into MLL and back. MLL back to HLL. But here examples are C, C++, VB, VC, VC++, like this. Okay. These languages, these whatever the program we will write in these languages, for them we need the compiler to convert into ones and zeros. So again, to get the results back into HLL, we need the compiler. So compiler, it is the second type of the translator, which converts high level language into machine level language and machine level language back to machine level language back to high level language. But the main difference, both definitions are same, interpreter and compiler both are same, but the thing is that interpreter, it is very very slow, compiler it is very very fast. Interpreter nowadays we are not going to use. Again, in differences later on we can study. Compiler nowadays we use, because compiler is, it is used for C language, C++, VB, VC, Java, like that. Nowadays we are going to use those languages only to develop the projects. That's why compiler is, it is very very important as compared to interpreter. Interpreter nowadays we are not using, compiler only we are using. Okay. So that is the definition of compiler, second one. Then we can deal with third one, assembler. Assembler we can check. Assembler, how we can define assembler? So based on previous lessons, continuation, one by one I am continuing assembler. So here assembler. Assembler I am going to define like this. Assembler is defined as, it is a code converter, it is a translator, it will convert one programming language to another and vice versa. What it will convert? When I am building assembler, assembler it will convert ALL, assembly level language, that is MUP language. What is MUP language? In previous class I have given 8088, 8085, 8086, like this, 8086, so on. So assembly level language, mnemonic codes into machine level language, ones and zeros, and vice versa means back. ALL into MLL, MLL back to ALL. That will be converted by the assembler, where assembler is called as a translator or code converter. So you can consider these interpreter, compiler, assemblers, these are called as the softwares. You can consider them as the softwares because we are going to develop them. Okay. So especially these are called as utility softwares, like antivirus, like that. Okay. So once again I am going to revise all three. Translator, it is a code converter which will convert one programming language to another one. Three types of translators are there. So interpreter, compiler, assembler. Interpreter, it converts HLL into MLL and back, but the interpreter is, it is very very slow and it is used for basic, logo, COBOL, like that. That nowadays we are not using. Compiler, compiler it is used to convert HLL into MLL and vice versa. Back, back must be pronounced, because I am telling repeatedly in some books they will give only HLL into MLL. That is wrong. HLL into MLL is wrong for interpretatory compiler. We have to tell HLL into MLL, MLL back to HLL or vice versa. That is correct now. So compiler, it converts HLL into MLL and vice versa. MLL back to HLL, because we have to understand. We can understand only high level language. We cannot understand machine level language. That's why vice versa or back must be there. Okay, compiler, both definitions same, both figures same, means what is the main use differences? Again, so many are there, we can study. But main difference is, main purpose is, it is very fast. It will compile the program. It will check the program for the errors or the mistakes very fast, spontaneous. It takes a lot of time. It will halt in the middle only. That's why nowadays we are not using this. We are using assembler. So assembler is defined as, it is a code converter or language converter. So it is used to convert one programming language into another programming language. Which one programming language? Assembly level language, second type of language. So assembly level language, what it includes? Mupil language. Mupil language, what it includes? Mnemonic codes. What are mnemonic codes? So mnemonic codes are the abbreviations of two or more than two letters. ADD, SUB, HLT, DO, like that. So many are there. So that will be converted into MLL and MLL back to ALL. That will be done by the assembler. Hence, translator, three types of translators: interpreter, compiler, assembler. Interpreter, HLL to MLL back, but slow. Compiler, HLL to MLL back, but it is very fast. So assembler, it is going to convert ALL into MLL and vice versa. So it is also fast. This one fast. Nowadays we are using these two. So these are used for the programming language, C, C++, like that. These are used for the 8085, 8086, 8088, 8082, 86, that microprocessor languages. So hence the lesson. This completes the session 6. Thank you. Have a nice day. Differences in this, all these things, differences in next class, we can study in detail. Thank you. Have a nice day. We can conclude this one. So we can stop here. We can meet in next session 7.